today in my first YouTube video, I'm going to show you guys how I make my stickers from start to finish, which means from designing to production. I had wanted to make this video for a very long time, but somehow there's always some mistake with my Cricut machine, so I couldn't make this. Until yesterday, me and my dad figured out how to use the machine and how to fix the errors I was experiencing. So yesterday I made these small sized sticker sheet, which was a success. So I'm going to show you guys how I do that. So the first thing I do is open up Photoshop and set the canvas size to A4 so that I could cut it to A5 or whatever smaller size later. And I put my keyboard here so it's easier to access. I tuck it under the tablet. And on my computer, I will open up Pinterest or other website for referencing. The sticker sheet I want to design today is animal themed, so I'm going to draw a bunch of animals in my style. So let's get working. It took around 1 hour for me to finish this sketch. I said it would be animal themed, but while I was stylizing the animals, I really liked the design of this bear. So I decided to go with Goldilocks and the three bears as the theme. So when I designed the entire sticker sheet, I tried to keep in mind how the overall layout will look so that it will look good as a sticker sheet. So now that the sketch is finished, we can go and do the lining and coloring. And maybe I'll move around the pieces a little. So now I finished coloring and lining the entire sticker sheet. So I'm going to add a colored layer underneath all of them and then draw the cut line. So I finished adding the die cut to the design, and it looks like this. The lines look like this, and I exported it without the background color as a PNG, so it's over here. So the next thing I will do is to, oh my god, where's my mouse? Okay, so the next thing I will do is to open a new project in the Cricut and then upload the image. I'll just drag the file to the app and select complex. And because I already did the die cut in Photoshop, I don't have to do anything here. And then I can just click continue. I will save it as a print and cut image. Okay, so now I will select this and insert it. It's gonna be huge when you first insert it, so you can minimize it. Okay, so we're gonna make it smaller. And from now on, it's just a lot of testing, because you have to see if it will fit on one sheet. For the smaller designs, I usually do four full sheets of designs in one of these files, but I want to do two in this one so that the stickers are bigger. So I'm gonna click make it to see how it will look. And now you can see it's a little too big, so it's separated into two sheets. So I'm going to fix the size smaller. Now it's still too big, so we'll do that again. We're gonna fix it until it fits. So now it fits. So I'm going to print it. So if the whole thing is okay, we can stick it to the mat. And it doesn't matter where you stick it as long as it's perpendicular to the grid, because it can sense the marks. So then I'll put it into the machine and make sure this thing here is set to custom so that the pressure of the blade only cuts through the sticker part and not the whole sheet. So here I have a setting called premium vinyl textured, which I customized to be the right pressure. I'll click this, and then when I loaded the tools and mat, we can select go.
and it came with stuff at all, then really just look at the image on its own. I used to torture myself by making myself do these like really, really long, tedious little bits of texture and detail, because I thought that inherently putting more time into your art makes it.
Can we go class?
Can we do
theater section? Can we do it?
I like this better.
Fine. So yesterday, my sister designed another sticker sheet for the tortoise and the hare, but when it went through the sticker cutting machine, it cut all the little holes in the line. Oh my god, why is it on autofocus? Okay, it's here. It cut all the little lines, so there are little holes in all of the lines. So we have to fix that. Disgusting. So after the whole thing has been cut by the machine, I will cut this whole thing into two sticker sheets like this with this. So after I cut them, I will use this to cut off the edges because I think they look more complete with the round edges. I write the number of the stickers on all of them and then I draw something on it, and thank you for whoever will buy this sticker sheet. I mean, I say a thank you to whoever is going to buy the sheet. Then I put them in a pile and put it over here so I can package them easier. And the bits that are left over from the cutting will be saved up in this little box so I can draw on them later and give those small stickers as gifts to whoever orders in my store. So because the Cricut machine takes forever to cut the stickers, I will say goodbye to you all here. And if you want me to make a video about how I do my embroidered products, comment below. And then if you have any suggestions for videos or ways I could improve, you can also leave it in the comments below. I'm hoping to put out at least one new product every week until there are a full inventory at my shop, and I also want to put out studio vlogs, so I will need some suggestions. Thank you.